Good morning, children. In the previous class, you have studied about the South Indian dynasty, isn't it? In that, Shatavahanas. They were the first kingdom to establish in the Deccan. But today, let us study about the first kingdom established in the Karnataka. Who were they? They were Kadambas. The Kadambas ruled from 325 CE to 540 CE. Who was the famous ruler of the Kadambas? Mayura Varma was the famous ruler of the Kadambas. He ruled from 345 to 365 CE. He was the founder of and the great king of the Kadamba dynasty. He adopted the Kshatriya way and came to be known as Mayura Varma instead of Mayura Sharma because he was insulted by the Pallava king Shivaskanda Varma. So he was a Brahmin. Mayura Sharma was a Brahmin and he was not able to rule the kingdom. It was said by Shivaskanda Varma, the Pallava king. After he was insulted by the Pallava king, he adopted the Kshatriya way of life and became Mayura Varma. And after he became the Mayura Varma, he defeated the Pallava king in the war and established the Kadamba Empire. This is the Kadamba Empire, children. These places were ruled by the Kadambas. Banavasi is here. Banavasi was the capital of Kadambas. In the art and architecture, Mudukeshwara temple was famous architecture of the Kadambas. It was believed that this temple of Shiva, that is the Mudukeshwara temple, is the temple of Shiva, and it was built by Mayura Sharma. He was known as Mayura Varma. The Mudukeshwara temple was built in the 9th century and dedicated to Lord Shiva, the supreme god in the Shaivism. Shaivism believed in Lord Shiva, so it was they built that temple, and Mudukeshwara temple is located in the Banavasi, which is the capital of Kadambas, an ancient town on the border of Uttara Kannada and Shivamogga district. It is believed that Mayura Sharma built the first king of the Kadamba dynasty. Now, what were their contributions in the field of administration? The Kadambas made special contributions to Karnataka and Indian culture. There were political unity for around 300 years under the Kadamba rule. There was political unity. There was no controversies among the Kadambas. There was political unity. And there was a royal priest, ministers and military generals to play a significant role in the administration. Land revenue was the main source of income. Ajanta and Banavasi were the two important centers of Buddhism. Both Prakrit and Sanskrit became the court language, but people were speaking in Kannada. They built many bastis, that is a Jain shrine, and Agraharas, it is the group of Brahmin settlements. Here, this is also the residential school. Agrahara is also the residential school. Their land revenue was the main source of income. Ajanta and Banavasi were the important centers of Buddhism. And there was Prakrit and Sanskrit became the court language. And Kannada was the language of the people. They built many basdis, that is a Jain temple, and Agrahara for residential schools. This is about the Kadambas, children. Kadambas ruled from 325 CE to 540 CE. Mayura Varma was the famous king. He ruled from 345 to 365 CE. The Kadamba's capital was Banavasi. The most important architecture of these Kadambas were Mudukeshwara temple, that is the temple of Shiva. It was located in Banavasi and it is believed that it was built by Mayura Varma, and contributions were in the field of administration. There was unity around the 300 for around 300 years under the Kadamba rule. Land revenue was the main source of income. Ajanta and Banavasi were the two important centers of Buddhism. Prakrit and Sanskrit became the court language, and Kannada people were speaking Kannada. They built Jain bastis and Agraharas. It is a residential school. This is about the Kadambas. In the next class, let us study about the Gangas. Thank you, children.